I got into cancer research because my family members have been affected by cancer. I actually lost my grandpa. My wife's family, she's lost three aunts in the last 5 years.
My dad died of cancer. Lots of family members, we've all had family members die of cancer. When a patient comes in with a tumor, they get treated with chemotherapy, but eventually that tumor will become resistant to chemotherapy in most cases, and that's what eventually leads to the death of the patient. Our research is focused on how that tumor becomes resistant to the chemo, and if we can understand that, we can develop interventions to block it. In our effort to understand chemo resistance, we've focused on a few different processes that we think are really central to chemo resistance. And one of those has to do with this protein we call 1433, which is overexpressed in lots of different types of tumors. High levels of this protein in a tumor correlate with poor patient survival. We've uncovered a connection between 1433 and autophagy. When the cell doesn't have external sources of energy, it will activate autophagy and degrade its own components to produce energy. And that helps the cell survive through a brief period of chemo and become chemo resistant. So the type of work we do, there has to be a graduate student full-time on the project to push it forward.
And right now I'm working on a project focused on a protein called superoxide dismutase 1. We found a way that SOD1 functions in cellular respiration. And in the context of cancer, that's important because we found that SOD1 is able to assist cells under stress to continue to grow, which means that we now have a way to interfere with that growth.
Our lab's focus is chemo resistance, but out of that research, we sometimes make unexpected discoveries that lead us into other areas.
I would have to say that it is Dr. Andersen's leadership skills and research experience that have made my experience in this lab so valuable.
I believe that a successful lab has to be collaborative. Students have to communicate with each other and help each other. We're not just inside BYU. We go and present our research to the world at conferences, international conferences. And recently we've had the opportunity to give presentations at these conferences, which is a pretty big honor to be able to do that. We've got international collaborations now through these conferences. And so it's been a huge boost. All students in my lab get to publish.
I've been able to contribute to a significant publication, and I think that that's going to help launch my career.
Most of our projects were kind of at the beginning to middle stages, and there's years of research left.